गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू। सो कंटिन्यूइंग विद द लास्ट वीडियो, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट न्यू टॉपिक दैट इज मैनेजिंग डेटा रिसोर्सेज। सो मैनेजिंग डेटा रिसोर्सेज इज अ बिग टॉपिक, दिस थर्ड टॉपिक फ्रॉम द यूनिट नंबर 3। सो फ्रॉम लास्ट 3 or 4 videos we are discussing unit number 3, and name of the unit number 3 is leveraging information system. So leveraging stands, already discussed in the last video, leveraging stands for the benefits, okay, and what are the different benefits can be achieved for the information system. That is a major topic in this unit. The name of the unit itself is giving some idea, that is leveraging information system. So in that unit topic is, so when we talk about the information system, we are talking about the data or information that is coming in a huge amount. So which is in the huge amount, having a number of bytes, number of data records. So when we talk about the huge database, then we need to talk about the management of these big data files, big database system. So while managing the data resources, now what is meant by resources? The data is coming from all the ways, from all the platforms. When we talk about the Facebook, WhatsApp, any social medias, okay, so data is coming in a huge amount. So in the same line, when we are going to talk about the data, we need to talk about the information. So information is stored in computer files and hidden in the hierarchical manner. So when we say hierarchical manner, means there is a proper way of arranging the information. So when we say in the computer field, the information is basically gets arranged in bit pattern. That is initially it is in bit pattern, then 8-bit equivalent 1 byte, then byte pattern, then field, the small area, then make the records of these fields, collection of 12 more fields, making the record, and collection of more records, simply creating a file, and the collection of files is creating the data. So every bit, every pattern of the information, from bit, file, field, records, file, database, is having some memory space in the computer, and the computer scientist data or information, or store this data or information in these patterns, from the small 8-bit pattern, 1-bit pattern, 2-bit pattern, to the large and deep database. When we talk about the big database, then it needs to be managed properly. Now another thing is that whenever the database or the information we are collecting, so what are the different characteristics of good information? So good information, what is the information we are having? So what is the characteristics of this good information? The very first characteristic is timelineness. Timelineness, then appropriateness, accuracy, complete, current, and reliable. So whatever the data or information we are having, that is, when we talk about good information, we need to talk about the timelineness. It is the updated and according to the user's current need. Appropriate data should be there. There should not be errors or faults or the wrong information. Accuracy, data should be accurate in the physical format. So there are two logical view and critical view. The data should be accurate according to the expectations of the end user. It should be complete, it should not be the
incomplete or not in the proper format. It should be the completeness, then it should be current updated data, it should be the relevant. So there should not be any irrelevant data, so it should not be, then it becomes the time consuming and the decision taking will get delayed. So data is coming, if good information, good data, then that data should be relevant, that data should be timeline-based, appropriate, accuracy, complete and current. So what is the use of this? This simply helps to take a quick decision even the database is big or larger. And what is the information system basic key points? Quick response and right information. The right place, the right person at the right time. So these are the keywords in the information system. So when we talk about the information system management, we need to talk about the data resource management. And data resource management should be like this. It helps to improve the decision making and the quick response. So these are some keywords. Let me show you some slides where we will get some more keywords and more clear idea. See the slides. So from this first slide, we are getting some keywords, how the managing the data resources is happening. So managing the data resources, an information system provides user with timely, accurate and relevant information. Abhi hum log ne jo keywords dekhe, ki information should be timely, is updated and on the right time, without delay. Information should be accurate and information should be relevant. So Indian Railway is a good example, to the best example rahega. Large database hota hai IRCTC ka, aur data resources har every person is creating its PNR and data. So in that case, if you get a timely response, accurate response, then you can decide about your journey, future journey, or your reservation should be continue or you may need to cancel. So अगर ऐसा सारा इंफॉर्मेशन आपको टाइम पे मिलता है, so and so only you can go for the quick decision. That is improving the decision making. The information is stored in computer files. Obviously, every information is in the form of files. When files are properly arranged and maintained, user can easily access and retrieve the information when they need. Obviously, जब files सारे ठीक से arrange है, maintain है, then user can access them fastly and retrieve them from the even the database is large. If the files are not properly managed, they can lead to confusion, chaos in information processing. So if files are not properly managed, database is not properly arranged, then the information processing is get delayed or it may cause to the chaos or the confusion. So even if the hardware and software are excellent, the information system can be very inefficient because of poor file management. So file management, data management, information management, data resource management is very important. Even you are having all kinds of brilliant and excellent hardware and software, but your management of the file system information is not proper, then it simply goes for the poor file management, goes for the inefficient system. So file organization terms and concept. A computer system organizes data in hierarchy that starts with the bit. Bit represents 0 and 1. Obviously, we have just discussed it. Bit ke baad aata hai byte. In byte, it simply the collection of 8 bits. 8 bits are grouped to form a byte. Each byte represents one character, number, or symbol. So, accordingly, the byte going to represent the character, number, and symbol. Bytes can be grouped to form a field. It can represent a person's name or age. Related fields can be grouped to form a record. Related fields can be student's name, course. Related records can be grouped to form a file, and related files can be grouped to form a database. So, अभी भी हमने board पे जो लिखा है, whatever we have seen on the board, that is a bit, byte, field, records, file, and database. This is the proper hierarchy for the managing the data resources. So data hierarchy क्या कह रहा है देखो, from the bottom नीचे से ऊपर की तरफ बात करते हैं हम लोग. So bit can be the zero, can be the one. Byte can be the letter or its collection of 8 bits. Then field can be any informative section, that is a name, student name. Okay. Then fields collectively form a record. Record of name, course, and grade. So there are more than two or three fields, more than two fields. And when the records are collectively gathered, then we have a file. And these files can be a large number in a common single database, that is, we can say the student database. So this is the proper data hierarchy that we need to take care while managing the data resources. फाइल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन की फील्ड क्या होता है, तो एनी प्राइमरी की और द एनी इम्पोर्टेंट फील्ड दैट गिव्स, इफ यू हैव दैट पर्टिकुलर आइडेंटिफायर फील्ड नेम, देन यू कैन रिट्रीव द रिकॉर्ड ऑफ ऑल द आइडेंटिफायर्स, यू कैन रिट्रीव रिकॉर्ड ऑफ ऑल द फाइल. सो दैट अ पर्टिकुलर की, एवरी रिकॉर्ड इन द फाइल शुड कंटेन एट लीस्ट वन फील्ड दैट यूनिकली आइडेंटिफाइज दैट रिकॉर्ड, सो दैट द रिकॉर्ड कैन बी रिट्रीव और डेटेड और स्टोर. This identifier field is called a key field. So key field हर database में होना चाहिए. वो ऐसा एक record रहेगा uniquely identified करने वाला. If you have that particular key field, then you can retrieve whole database. You can retrieve that whole record. You can update it. You can store it. So and we will go to the next. So accessing records from computer files. Computer files से आपको record अगर access करना है. So very first thing, you know, computer system, the data can be arranged in a sequential manner or data can be arranged in a random manner. So it is the database who is responsible for arranging the data or files. So data and files are stored on the secondary storage device, जिसे हम लोग hard disk कहते हैं. Records can be arranged in several ways on storage medium. How individual record can be accessed or retrieved depends on how they are arranged or stored. There are mainly two ways to organize record, that is a sequential record and a random record. So in the previously, whatever the traditional file system is there, traditional file environment is there, they are having some difficulties, having some problems. So one problem is data redundancy. मतलब बार-बार वही data record हो जाता था. Repetitive data copy हो जाता था, record हो जाता था. So repetitive data should not be there and that should be avoided. But this is a problem with traditional file organization, data redundancy. So is the presence of duplicate data in the multiple data files. In this situation, confusion results because the data can be different meaning in different files. So this is very important sentence. Data may have the different meaning in the different files. Data independence. Data should be independent. Data independence is the right relationship between data stored in files and specific programs required to update and maintain those files. Data consistency. Data consistency refers to the requirement that any given database transaction must change affected data only in allowed way. And the last is the data security is a very important thing that is having a lack in the traditional file organization. And current new file organizations, new database management is having the highest priority to the data security. So data security is a prior problem resulting from the lack of control over the data because it is widespread and distributed into so many files. So this is the problem with the traditional system because data is gets spread in a wide manner, in a distributed manner into the number of files. So it becomes very difficult to arrange, manage, and secure such a data. Data access refers to software activities and related to storing, retrieving, and activity on data, household, and other repository. Data administration is the process by which data is monitored, maintained, and managed by data administrator. Data administration is the process and the monitor by the data administration. Managing concurrency and recovery from crashes. So if you manage all these things, then you can manage the concurrency, you can go for the quick recovery from crashes. So what is meant by database and what is meant by data management system? Because हमने देखा कि डेटा हायरार्की में मैनेज करना है, तो डेटाबेस क्लास जो है हायरार्की का, वी नीड टू सी व्हाट इज अ डेटाबेस. डेटाबेस इज अ कलेक्शन ऑफ डेटा ऑर्गेनाइज्ड टू सर्विस मेनी एप्लीकेशंस इफेक्टिवली बाय सेंट्रलाइजिंग द डेटा एंड मिनिमाइजिंग रिडंडेंट डेटा. सो डेटाबेस वो सिस्टम है, वो कलेक्शन ऑफ डेटा है जहाँ पे डेटा ऑर्गेनाइज किया जाता है इस तरीके से कि वो इफेक्टिवली सेंट्रलाइज हो, एज वेल एज वो डेटा इफेक्टिवली नॉन कंकरेंट हो, मतलब मिनिमाइज रिडंडेंट डेटा हो, बार बार वही डेटा रिपीट नहीं हो. सो पर्टिकुलर सिस्टम को मैनेज सच ए डेटाबेस इज कॉल्ड अ डेटाबेस मैनेजमेंट सिस्टम. टेक्निकल डेफिनेशन देखते हैं. और डेटाबेस मैनेजमेंट सिस्टम इज अ स्पेशल सॉफ्टवेयर दैट परमिट्स एन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन टू सेंट्रलाइज डेटा, मैनेज इट एफिशिएंटली एंड प्रोवाइड एक्सेस टू द स्टोर डेटा बाय एप्लीकेशन प्रोग्राम्स. तो डेटाबेस मैनेजमेंट सिस्टम वो सिस्टम है, वो सॉफ्टवेयर सिस्टम है जो ऑर्गेनाइज करती है सेंट्रलाइज डेटा को, उसको प्रॉपरली मैनेज करती है, शेड्यूल करती है इफेक्टिवली एक्सेस के लिए, और वो प्रोवाइड करती है एंड यूजर को, एप्लीकेशन प्रोग्राम्स को, व्हाट एवर द डेटा इज स्टोर्ड एंड व्हाट एवर द डेटा इज रिक्वायर्ड. सो सच अ सिस्टम हु मैनेजिंग दिस ऑल दिस थिंग्स इज कॉल्ड एज अ डेटाबेस मैनेजमेंट सिस्टम. डेटा डेफिनेशन लैंग्वेज, डेटा मैनिपुलेशन लैंग्वेज एंड डेटा डिक्शनरी, दीज आर द थ्री डेफिनेशंस. देन देयर आर टू व्यूज ऑफ द डेटा. डेटा कैन बी लॉजिकल व्यू और फिजिकल व्यू. लॉजिकल व्यू मतलब डेटा इज परस्यूड बाय एन यूजर ऑफ बिजनेस स्पेशलिस्ट, जो उसको रिट्राइव करते हैं फिर वो अपने हिसाब से उसको कंसिडर करते हैं, बट वो उनके हिसाब से लॉजिकल व्यू है. वॉट एवर द डेटा दे आर गोइंग टू परस्यूड बाय द एंड यूजर एंड बिजनेस स्पेशलिस्ट, दैट्स द लॉजिकल व्यू. फिजिकल व्यू मतलब वो एक्चुअल डेटा जिस फॉर्मेट में है, जहाँ जैसा ऑर्गेनाइज किया हुआ है, जैसे वहाँ उसको फिजिकल स्टोरेज किया हुआ है, स्ट्रक्चर किया हुआ है. सो लॉजिकल व्यू इज द व्यू डेटा इज परस्यूड बाय एंड यूजर, एंड फिजिकल व्यू इज द व्यू डेटा इज एक्चुअली ऑर्गेनाइज, एक्चुअली स्ट्रक्चर, एक्चुअली फिजिकली स्टोर्ड ऑन द मीडिया. सो एक्चुअल स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ द डेटा इज कॉल्ड एज द physical view, logical view is considered view. So advantages of database management system, data confusion kam ho jata hai, data redundancy kam ho jati hai, flexibility of information system badh jati hai, access fast ho jata hai, information system ke sabse bada importance characteristics hai, accessing and quick response. Program data dependency reduce ho jati hai. So these are some advantages of database management system. So there are some more points about the distributed system, that is a distributed database and organization database. We will see these points about the database management system in the next video. So till now we have discussed about the database management system and the database. That is, we have talked about the database. Database kya hota hai? It is a collection of data files on a collective manner, so and in a scheduled manner, so the end user or application programmer can access it with fast, quick response. So database management system or management system that manages all the such a database so that the quick response and accessing the records and data will be fast. So data can be arranged in a database system or by the other physical storage, you know, logical view and physical view. It can be in a sequential manner or it can be in a random manner. So these are just some keywords we need to consider and you need to remember. So continuing with this next point, agle video mein hum database management system kya hota hai deep mein dekhenge, distributed database kya hota hai, sequential database kya hota hai, normalization of database kya hota hai, we will discuss about these points in the next video. So for today, thank you to all of you. Thanks.